This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video focuses on how to use cash flow information to evaluate the performance of companies. So I have separate videos that describe the statement of cash flows and how to create the statement of cash flows and the information that's provided there. But then this video describes how to take that information and evaluate and use it to evaluate the performance of a company. And it, we all know, hopefully, that companies must manage their cash effectively and generate cash flow from the core business. The cash flow can be analyzed in a number of different ways, and there are three different measures that we're going to be talking about in this video. We're going to be talking about the operating cash flow ratio, the capital expenditure ratio, and the free cash flow measure. Let's start by talking about the operating cash flow ratio. And we'll discuss, first of all, what it represents and then how we calculate it. So the operating cash flow ratio measures a company's ability to generate enough cash, and the key here is from the daily operations, over the course of a period of time, we're going to use a year in our example, to cover current obligations, which we often call current liabilities. So how do we find the operating cash flow ratio? And the formula is shown right here. So we start by pulling information from the statement of cash flows, and that's the numerator. We're going to take the cash provided by operating activities. That's the top part of the statement of cash flows. So cash provided by operating activities, which indicates the cash that we generate, hopefully generate, and not use, from the daily operations of the business. And then we're going to divide that by the current liabilities, and that comes straight from the balance sheet. The current liability portion of the balance sheet. So those are the liabilities in general that we have to pay off within a year. So we want to know if we're generating enough cash from our core business to be able to pay off the current liabilities that are sitting on the balance sheet. So a ratio that is higher than one would indicate that, yes, we do generate enough cash from operating activities to be able to cover our current liabilities. Here's the operating cash flow ratio that's been calculated for Home Depot and for Lowe's, two companies that are in a similar industry. So Home Depot, in looking at their operating cash flow ratio, their ratio is 0.73, and we calculate that by taking their cash that is provided by operating activities, and that turns out to be right here, this number, number of $8,242,000,000, and we divide that by their current liabilities, and their current liabilities totaled $11,269,000,000, and you'll see here then that their operating cash flow ratio is 0.73. And then if we do the same thing for Lowe's, you will see that their ratio is 0.53. So here are the operating cash flow ratios for each of these companies. You'll notice that they're below one, and so they do not generate enough cash from operating activities to cover their current liabilities on the balance sheet. Our next ratio is the capital expenditure ratio. And we're going to again talk about how what it means and how we calculate it. So the capital expenditure ratio measures the company's ability to generate enough cash from their daily operations to cover their capital expenditures. And a number greater than one indicates that the company is able to cover their investments solely from cash provided by operating activities. Now, I realize companies can generate cash other ways and oftentimes will finance the purchase of long-term assets. Capital expenditures refers to long-term assets. So this is one measure. There are other measures, but this is one measure just to see if there is enough cash generated from the daily operations of the business to cover their capital expenditures. We find this capital expenditure ratio by taking the cash provided by operating activities, that comes again right from the statement of cash flows, top part, and we divide that by the capital expenditures, that is the investments in fixed assets that the company has made. The capital expenditure information in general will come from the investment activity section of the statement of cash flows. So we can take a look at the investment activity section and see exactly how much cash companies have spent on their long-term assets. Again, we have information here for Home Depot and for Lowe's in this chart. And the capital expenditure ratio for Home Depot is 5.72, and for Lowe's is 5.60. For Home Depot, we take the cash provided by operating activities, again, right from the statement of cash flows, and that is $8,242,000,000, and we divide it by their investment in long-term assets, things like buildings and equipment, of $1,442,000,000. And you'll see that the resulting capital expenditure ratio is 5.72. So this tells us that both companies have generated plenty of cash from their operating activities to be able to cover their investments in long-term assets. Next, we'll take a look at the free cash flow measure, and we'll look at how it's calculated again and talk about what it tells us. The free cash flow is a variation, basically, of the capital expenditure ratio. It uses the same information, and it's based on the idea, we'll show you the formula in just a second, it's based on the idea that companies must invest in fixed assets, long-term assets, to remain competitive. Think about a company like Facebook. They have to continue to invest in servers places to warehouse those servers as their user base grows. So they're going to continue to invest in fixed assets and long-term assets to continue to grow the business. The third bullet point here, we find the capital expenditure ratio by taking the cash provided by operating activities and subtracting capital expenditures. Remember, in the previous measure, we took the cash provided by operating activities divided by capital expenditures. So here we subtract capital expenditures to come up with how much cash is left over after investing in long-term assets, how much cash is left over from our daily operations after investing in long-term assets or fixed assets. So many companies consider this measure to be important. It's an important way to evaluate their financial performance. Especially companies that are growing that need to invest in long-term assets, they want to try to generate enough cash from their day-to-day operations to cover those investments. So going back to the same information for Home Depot and Lowe's, we can calculate the free cash flow amount. And again, we're using the same information. We're going to take the cash provided by operating activities, and here it is $8,242,000,000. For Home Depot, and we're going to subtract the capital expenditures of $1,442,000,000, and you'll see that Home Depot has free cash flow of $6,800,000,000. I just noticed that I have an error here, so I put three additional zeros on the end because it's not $6,800,000, it's $6,800,000,000. So that is the free cash flow for Home Depot, and the free cash flow for Lowe's is $4,049,000,000. This tells us that both companies have plenty of cash left over from operating activities after covering their investments in long-term assets. So this slide simply shows a summary of the cash flow measures that we just talked about. The first being the operating cash flow ratio, and we find that by taking the cash provided by operating activities right off of the statement of cash flows, divided by current liabilities, which comes right from the balance sheet, and that gives us the ratio. And then the second is the capital expenditure ratio, and this is found by using the same numerator, cash provided by operating activities from the statement of cash flow, and dividing it by the capital expenditures, or what are often called investments in long-term assets. And that can be found in the investment activities section of the statement of cash flows. And the third measure is free cash flow, which is cash provided by operating activities. And we subtract then from that our capital expenditures. And that gives us how much cash is left over from operating activities after covering our investment in long-term assets.